Welcome to
Smarter Driving.
4-5-6-9-8 Pebble Creek W. Shelby Township, Michigan. Sponsored by Four Seasons Kangaroo.
Bill Jr. here for Kangaroo, where we talk to you. At your office, do you notice that your gutters hang low? Do they wobble to and fro? Well, if they do, it's time to let our experts hop to it for you. Right now, for a very limited time, we are offering 10% off any commercial or business gutter replacement, gutter repair, gutter cleaning, or heck, even a gutter guard. Quit settling for your pickup truck chuck that never quite solves your problem. Visit kanga-roof.com. Choose
Kangaroo. We have to it.
Now, there's another way to listen for the latest news. Ask Alexa to tune in WWJ. This watch never stops. News Radio 950.
News time 10:55. It is time to check your money. Here's Bloomberg's Ed Corey.
hatchback and its slightly bigger cousin, the Bolt EUV. At a time of low supply, with dealers often charging thousands of dollars over a sticker, GM actually slashed the price of these electric models by about $6,000. Bloomberg says GM may be trying to buy a bigger share of the EV market while it ramps up production of newer top dollar models. Right now, the Dow is down 679 points. I'm Ed Corey with the Bloomberg Business Report on WWJ News Radio 950.
Lottery numbers at the top of each hour on WWJ. Last night's daily 3749, the daily 45778. Traffic and weather coming up in 2 minutes.
Tatiana White's high school graduation brought family from Georgia, Maryland, and Connecticut. Beach, Florida.
Did getting here cost you more than you thought it would?
But vacation inflation has them spending more for just about everything. Evelise Cruz came from Hartford.
What was your budget? Where do you think you'll end up?
I mean, I wanted to keep it anywhere between $2,000. I'll probably be close to $4,000 by the end of this.
Domestic airfare is costing flyers like Cruz 34% more than 2019. The real budget killer? That all too familiar, pain at the pump.
AAA says the average price of a gallon of regular gas is almost $4.99 today. Stocks are down well over 2% right now. The Dow off 733. S&P down 102. International travelers won't have to show proof of negative COVID tests to enter the U.S. anymore. CBS's Steve Dorsey from Washington.
The testing requirement will end Sunday, but a White House official says the CDC could reimpose the testing measure in 90 days if things like a new COVID-19 variant concerns public health officials. The White House says it follows what it calls tremendous progress against the virus.
Americans watched violent, never-before-seen footage of the January 6th attack on TV last night. Congressman Adam Kinzinger, one of only two Republicans on the January 6th investigating team, spoke to CBS Mornings.
I think Donald Trump is very mentally incapable of being president, but I think he knew that these were lies, but he was desperate for anything he could grasp to stay in power, because he can't lose.
CBS News chief political analyst John Dickerson.
The thing that's most vital about this is not some event in the past. This is about whether the democracy can handle the peaceful transfer of power, and that's a question of the present, and it's a question of our future.
President Trump messaging today on his Truth Social platform, calling former Attorney General William Barr a coward and lambasting his daughter Ivanka, who was seen testifying last night. It'll be another day of record-setting heat in the South. Meteorologist David Parkinson.
Record high temperatures stretch a large area. They stretch from California all the way to Texas. We've got triple-digit temperatures across Texas, including triple digits in Dallas. We'll probably get to 100 and 203 in Austin and San Antonio.
S&P off 107 right now. This is CBS News.
Get CBS News Radio on the Odyssey app. All the audio that matters to you is on Odyssey. News, music, sports, and podcasts. Download the Odyssey app today.
From Plymouth and Plymouth Township, surrounding the area in Farmer and Carmada Streets, just north of the downtown Main Street. Police are asking people to stay away. However, dispatchers are not giving us information as to what is going on. We do have our reporter, Ryan Marshall, headed to the scene. Stay with us. We'll pass along the information as soon as we know. Reporting live, Sandra McNeil, WWJ News Radio 950.
The driver in a hit-and-run crash that injured a 6-year-old Pontiac girl has turned himself into police. WWJ's Greg Bowman live with the latest. Greg.
Good morning, Brooke. Oakland County Sheriff says the driver of the SUV that struck a 6-year-old Pontiac girl as she was crossing the street this week then sped away was arrested last night. The driver, a 23-year-old Pontiac man, surrendered to detectives in the Oakland County Sheriff's Office Pontiac substation shortly after 11 p.m. Thursday. Detectives now seeking charges against the man for leaving the scene of a personal injury accident. He's being held in the Oakland County Jail. Sheriff Michael Bouchard says he is pleased the suspect is in custody, and he's convinced that happened because of the pressure from our hardworking detectives to locate the suspect, as well as a lot of help from the community. Reporting live, Greg Bowman, WWJ News Radio 950.
A Grand Rapids police officer who killed a motorist during a struggle with a shot to the back of the man's head is being arraigned today on charges of second-degree murder. Prosecutor Chris Becker announced the charges yesterday against Grand Rapids officer Christopher Schur, who killed Leoya following a chaotic traffic stop on April 4th. The 26-year-old was on the ground when he was killed. A bystander recorded the shooting on cell phone. Schur told Leoya that he stopped his car because the license plate didn't match the vehicle. Defense attorneys say Leoya's death was a tragedy but not murder. They say the officer feared for his safety. Just hours after the criminal charge was announced, Grand Rapids Police Chief Eric Winstrom says he is starting the process to have the officer fired.
Based on the information that I have available to me at this time, I intend to recommend the city manager immediately suspend Officer Schur without pay, pending termination. I recognize the impact this will have on a longtime employee and a friend of many at the Grand Rapids Police Department, but I think it is the right thing to do.
Winstrom said he respects the decision of the prosecutor and that the decision was made strictly on the use of force.
tonight remaining mostly cloudy, quiet, low 56. Tomorrow, not a bad day, times of sun and clouds. Shower and spots for the afternoon, high 75. Sunday a bit more active with mainly cloudy skies and a couple showers around, high 79. Drying out for Monday with times of sun and clouds, high of 80 degrees. Then things warm up for Tuesday. Can't roll out a thunderstorm early, then temperatures rebound with a high of 88. Cracky weather. I'm here with Matt Benz on WFJ News Radio 950.